Yes, I'm having a night of a log here. I'm not feeling very kind. I'm not in a kind of phase. When you have like, oh, everybody is there's hope for our humanity. And there's hope for ecology. I'm just not in that phase. I'm in that, oh no, it's a downward spiral. We're not getting out. It's a black hole that we are headed into, ecologically, you know, losing so much, such a vast group so quickly. And then you can say, well, and somebody will say, no, we're not, blah, blah, blah. But we are losing animals quite quickly. We have this. We still have about 150,000 elephants, I believe, worldwide, so that's a good thing. But, you know, then you hear that, you know, they had a whole bunch that were killed, you know, very many, like, I think it was like 90. So yeah, those types of things are damning to the ecological recovery. Of the whole deal, you know, because we need the elephant dung for the savanna, for those trees, for the fertilization. You can't take them away, or you end up with a bowl, like a Kansas bowl, those Midwestern, what was that woman with her shoes, Julie Andrews, no, the other one, that's when she clicks her heels, Judy Garland and her little doggy off to Oz. You end up with that scenario all over Africa because we don't have that excitement any longer, even from their excrement existing, to team in and have the worms that did compost the soil. And lastly, when that occurs, you know, other things happen, more plants, more da 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 da, it just keeps going on and on. And then it furthers into more insects, more exciting insects that we all adore, like butterflies, caterpillars and butterflies. And then furthers on to birds and lower species mammals, etc. So here we are, you know, we're losing now with every elephant that they take out, you know. So they're creating a dust bowl there. They took away all of our buffalo. I'm very, very, what can I say about that? They just took away the dust, they made a dust bowl, they took away the buffalo and made a dust bowl. So, anyway, so I'm having this ecological, like, wall, brick wall, we're looking at the brick wall, the ecological brick wall, and how do we get, I'm tired of talking about it, I'm tired of saying this is wrong and that's wrong, and these people are damners to ecological system of recovery. I don't know, man was just talking on the show, he said that the forest recovers very quickly, blah, 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 if it's protected and people just leave it alone. But then the other person says, well, if the animals that were supposed to be there are not any longer, then the forest cannot recover. So don't forget, if you don't have the animals, that forest was a very good, you know, like slap in the face to the original man, because he was just trying to tout that'll all recover, you know, just throw some money at it and buy it, protect it, it'll be brand new again. Well, no, you have to have those same species that were there with their droppings, with their bones, that were living and dying there to recreate that same environment. Otherwise, you just end up with this Luke Skywalker movies, where he's out there in Dune or out there with what was that, the Obi-Wan Kenobi style guy, Star Wars. Yes, you end up with that type of a of a planet. You know, it's just this, just this wind-blown hell that nothing else can survive, because all of the animals have been taken, all of the trees, all the plants, it's just been destroyed. But there it is again, you know, all I'm doing is restating, you know, what good is another restater, you know. We want the answer, we want the fix, and we're tired of having to say, okay, here's another $5 in donation out here. I get, there, a lot of these companies are so pushy on their donations, and I understand it's working for many of them, but, and that's maybe the only way that they can survive, to get, you know, buy land or do this or do that or the other. But when you have, that's the only answer, that's the only way, you know, it's the only way to change people's minds is, and unfortunately the people they end up spamming, the people they end up, you know, trying to double attract and triple attract and quadruple attract, they end up being the people that were already, no, I would never hurt them intentionally, I would never damn them or injure that forest intentionally, I would never do those things. And yet, those are the people that they're just trying to blood suck for, please, you know, give us money. So it becomes a real terrible campaign, because you're campaigning to the people that are, they're already obviously on your side. And these others that are just like these human cockroaches that are taken over, they're not listening, they're not learning, they're one syllable type of human beings. Literally, one syllable is pretty much they're one or two, you know, march 1-2, you know, that in the army, they can say one and two syllables very easily. But when they get to the third syllable and the fourth or fifth, or even more complicated, and the sixes and sevens, they cannot handle that much. You understand? And so we're dealing with brains that are really, really average. And so these average have become the norm. They've become, here I'm once little going, but they have become the normalcy of the planet's ecological future. And so I'm like, how come the most idiot humans are allowed such an incredulous banquet of our future? They're just given it on a platter. How can we, the ones that they're trying to, you know, continue and say, help and give, you know, or you know, everybody's yelling at me, go get like a, you know, $100,000 a year job, and sit at the desk all day. Can you please go and do that so we can blood suck you some more for some of that liberal cash? You know, that seems to be the agenda around my family anyway. That's what they want. The donator woman. And it's just like, where are we going when we're talking about billions of people that are completely ignorant, and they're the one and two syllables. Billions of people. I don't know. And they took a lot of the things away from schools. They take away a lot of the language. So we're not learning parler le français, we're not even learning that. We are not having time in the music. And so all of these things that enhance the brain and teach it to go a little extra mile, a little extra further, it's all just crunched back into this mega control human cockroach that just goes and eats and goes and pays a bill and goes to back to work and then goes and eats and then goes and pays a bill and goes back to work. And don't forget, puts gas in the car. Can I make that one more syllable, car? Can I make that another syllable? We don't even say vehicle anymore. That would be like, what's a vehicle? You know, what is a transportation device? They don't even know. Maybe they only know car, they know truck, and that's it. We're dealing with a brain that is, we make fun of the farmer who knows how many, 300 to 500 words. We make fun of this guy, the old adage farmer from the old days that used to exist. They don't exist any longer. We don't have that old adage farmer very often, but they were the 300 to 500 words. And when I hit France, I was like, that's it. I'm going to go there and I'm going to learn the 300 to 500 farmer words. And, you know, at least I'll be able to communicate. And I thought I was doing that, but they decided against me. I was an objectionable human being near their psyche of place and fortune. I was a thorn in their side, where they could have taken me on and they could have said, hey, teach English. They could have taken me on and said, hey, teach art. They could have taken me on and said, hey, teach singing. They could have done that. But instead, they decided to just, you know, just be that locality. Okay, so when they get locality, and they get provincial, that's back to that one-syllable word again. You know, stranger, you're a foreigner, you know, you're a stranger, you're different. And so that's another thing, you know, when you're dealing with this mind psyche, as it's marching forward in this ones and two syllables, there you are, you're like, you know, you're from Paris, or you're Parisian, you know, you're from Paris, okay, and so the Parisian will never get really along with a person who says from Paris, you know. That's never gonna happen. And here in America also, you can say, let's get some. And then you may even find that certain cities that have the longer syllable names will have a little turn up on that, what do we call it, education level brain scale, like, how many syllables is the name of your city? We have San Francisco, very interesting, because Francisco, we are three. It has a lot of new activity going on. You know, it's like a hotbed of new. And then we have Angeles, Los Angeles, another hotbed of new. You know, so we have the big movie center, and then we have a lot of the cultural improvements to this world, you know, going on in San Francisco. So we have that going on with the three syllables. I can't say the same for Miami though, because Miami has just become spring break out there in the hot heat. So, but let's think about those three syllables though. They're very interesting holds of change. Because even that, the spring break was a change place, wasn't it? You know, they take all of those kids out of school, and they're going to go dance in their bikinis for 2 or 3 weeks a year and have spring break. So, in a way, it is a next step, town type of thing. Where you can take the old-fashioned towns, like Houston, Dallas. You can take New Orleans. You could take old-fashioned towns, and they're just old-fashioned. They're never really going to change. I don't see any like big movement happening there. I don't see anything like that. So this is just a strange little observation I'm doing today with the syllables, because I believe the human being, the brains, are really controlled a lot by you know, the how we speak, the vocalizations, the number of vocabulary enhancements, or not in vocabulary enhancements, you know, when we get back to what? Get back to what? And yeah, there's a one syllable. and who, what, who, where, all of those one syllables, a lot of questions, a lot of inquisitives are in the one syllables. And a lot of the accusations are in the one syllables, the you, the I, the he, the them, the it, all one syllable. So a lot of accusations are easy to grab at for that lower echelon brain, the brain that is just, you know, I don't know what she said, you know. They can say that, but they can't say, I don't have the fairest a notion of what she was intending in her meaning. You know, they don't have that type of elocution skill. They're not able to make a roll with it, you know what I mean? And so where was I on the elocution downgrade? Because they never had the elocution to begin with. That's in school. That goes back to the teachers. That goes back to the training. That goes back to what they were taught. It goes back to foreign languages. If they are given any, or they're given any kind of developmental chance to learn estrellas, you know, just anything in another language, can they learn it? You know? And are Canadians actually smarter than Americans? We don't know. But Canadian, American, they look like the same to me. So, yeah, anyway, so that's kind of fun for a moment to think about it, but it isn't, because then I'm looking at that group, this human bed of no change, and they're dealing with this confrontational single syllables all the time, you know. You did this, you did that, and there's three syllables in the brain that actually got hit, dunk, dunk, dunk. And that's that accusation. It's very simple to do. It's very, very lazy. It's a very lazy brain that only has to say three syllables to accuse. Mm-hmm. Very lazy brain. So I back to this, we're talking about the greed, the greedy, removal of the greedy. Now, if they're greedy, is something that unfortunately they're greedy is we're dealing with the consumer greedy, that they're taught they're I mean, so many products they have no idea, they just go and grab at. And yes, they were used for animal testing, and that one was used for animal testing, and they've been majorly played out in the commercial game for years and years and years. And so it's like, well, it's in their head. They've been, you know, shaped. Their brain has been shaped to be cozy with those products, even though they were used for testing. So to remove that cozy, and to really to just jump out and say, hey, never again. Maybe they can't. And so I'm like, well. There's Peta, and they cram these, you know, vicious images of what they do to animals in their faces, you know. I mean, I'm sure they see them. I cannot believe, I still can't believe that the commercial advertising is that strong, that is that much of a hold on their brain, that is that much of a comfortable, cozy, like, I'm gonna just snuggle up. Oh, there's a good one for PETA. I'm gonna just snuggle up with that commercial, you know, that commercial advertisement. You know, like it's a nice cozy pillow, when in reality, that pillow is just drenched in blood and guts and pain and agony and hurt and many deaths, you know. So when we're dealing with that type of comfort pillow that they can't rationalize with, it's almost like the brain, their brain is non-accepting Okay, it's non-accepting, it's non-seeing, it's in denial. Their brain is in a denial stage. When we talk about tunnel vision, we can talk about, okay, that it's in a tunnel vision. They're a tunnel vision to this corporate agenda, the safe place. It's what my friends do, and I'm immature, and I can't do anything else but what my friends do. You know, if they have a party with burgers and hot dogs, I'm going to go too and eat them, you know, because I'm stupid, because it's a two-syllable word, you know. And so you have that person that is a follower. Yeah, you have that person that just goes and goes and goes, and he isn't, or she is in such denial of what happened to those animals. What happened to that animal testing for he or she to receive that item or object? They have the peer pressure, they have the commercial advertising plus peer pressure, and all of that has become a hold stronger. You know, that feast on their immaturity level. You know, just you know, he's my friend, and that's what we do. You know, and she's my friend, and that's what we do, and that's it. And then I just have a happy smiley face, like I go to Wonderland or whatever, and that's the way life goes, and we're all happy. You know, so you're just an interruption to my tunnel vision. You know, we're interrupting their tunnel vision. So yeah, so how does that help now that we're interrupting their tunnel vision? We're raining on their parade. Interrupting and raining on their parade. We're hurting their basic, I was so happy. I was so happy with the way my life was. And now you show up, and you're telling me I'm doing it wrong. You're telling me I'm eating wrong. You're telling me I can't use those products anymore. I resent you, you know. That's where they're coming from. They resent. They can handle resentment. They can handle resentment because we're attacking their tunnel vision. They like that common place. They like that's it, you know, this is my life. Beginning, middle, and end, tunnel vision. I'm going to use these products. I am going to eat this type of food. I am going to not listen about deforestation. I'm not going to listen about extinct animals. I'm not going to care one bit. I'm not going to care a thing about the animal testing. I'm not going to care. I'm just going to go tunnel vision the whole way and smile. And just keep putting blockades on. More and more blockades. And you're like, well, looks like there's a war. They're walking around with blockades, that's much. So they can keep shopping at those items, those products. They keep putting on those blockades so they can go buy more bacon. They keep putting on those blockades so they can have a coronary heart attack. They don't care. They keep putting on those blockades. There is a war. And you, who don't like their tunnel vision or don't want their tunnel vision, you're their enemy. It's very simple. Okay, so how does this solve anything? I don't know, because now we're back at this terrible place, and it's not even like Israel and Pakistan. It's not even that type of a thing. You know, we're not fighting over land or cultural religion here. You know, we're talking about pain. Like pain. Like one group is saying you don't have the right to give that much pain to animals. You don't have the right to take away them from the planet Earth. you don't have the right to take away our oxygen from the planet Earth. One group is saying all of these things, and the other group is saying, oh, we can do whatever we want, and live, c'est la vie, la 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 la. We can do whatever we want, because we have the corporations behind us. We have the big corporations, we have Donald Trump, we have all of these people behind us that just say burn and kill and burn and kill in our tunnel. Okay, anyway, so to those blockaders, is it plastic? I mean, is it plastic that they have? They've eaten so much plastic, there's plastic in their blockade? I don't know. I don't know. I don't know. But I'm definitely an enemy. I don't know, I guess that's life. Anyway. You know, it's changing. How do you change that blockade group out? Well, oddly, music, foreign languages, a lot of those things. Enhancement with those three syllable words, four syllables, five. Yeah. Omnidextrous. Oh my gosh. Even those silly ones, yes. Even those. And I'm not saying the medical words either are the way to go, because here we have that group. I've met some really mean, vicious doctors, and they are so money hungry that they are like a Nazi squad. You hit one of those hospitals, they will Nazi squad you in and won't let you leave. You have to yell and scream and fight to get out. I mean, I cannot believe it. I cannot believe the energy they have to keep you in that bed, to keep you overnight. Unbelievable. You or your whoever you took there, they have an agenda, and they are in business. They are in business to keep those beds full. So I have kind of an issue with them and their learning of those languages, of their four-letter, what do you call them, hemoglobin mod squads or whatever they are, them and their medical terminologies, you know, running around and strutting their life and saying, well, I have the medical terminology, so I'm really smart and I know better. No, you're just a fascist that has just done nothing at all but standardize in that tunnel. As a controller, that's your agenda, is to be a controller in the tunnel group. That's all you are. That's all you are. That's all you ever will be. So, anyway, that was my message to doctors, medical USA majority. And I'll say France also. And I'll say England also. Any chance for an operation extra given? Disgusting. Disgusting controllers that live in that tunnel with that tunnel group. What a stupid group you have to control. What a stupid group. So anyway, yeah. So I look at that controller group now, and I'm going, well, let's look at the leaders of it. Because it's surely not me. I'm not a leader of that tunnel group. Let's look at those leaders. There are major enemies. The leaders of that tunnel group.